a warning against relying on copies known as translation of the Holy Quran, in which the authors translated the words of the Quran word for word, and they fell into many mistakes. Don't ever think that if you are reading this translation, you are reading the Quran. No. You are reading what that author understood from the ayah and he translated into English. So you are reading actually what that person understood from the ayah. So you are putting yourself at a great risk. You cannot rely on these translations. And in the Arabic language, we mentioned that there are some words that have no similar in any other language, like the word istawa. Istawa has 15 meanings. There is no word in English or French or Italian or any other language that can replace this word istawa and give the same meaning. No way. The word istawa in the ayat means Allah subjugated the arsh by his power. Allah preserved the arsh from perishing because it's the ceiling of paradise. Allah made the arsh everlasting. It doesn't come to an end because it's the ceiling of paradise. That's the meaning of the ayah. But in the translations, we find in many books saying or using terms such as Allah sat on the throne. Or they say Allah established himself firmly on the throne. Or they say, and that's in one of the books, Allah mounted the throne, wal-iyazu billah. All these words are characteristics of the bodies, the creations. Allah is not a body, is not a tangible body that can be grasped by hands, and not an intangible body that cannot be grasped by hands. Allah mentioned in the Quran this ayah that Allah is the creator of the skies and earth, darkness and light, to tell us that all the bodies, whether they are tangible or intangible, are creations of Allah. And Allah does not resemble the creations. So Allah is not a tangible body and not an intangible body. But those translations are filled with wrong ideologies and beliefs, wal-iyazu billah, because they depend on what this author understood from these verses. One common mistake that we have seen in these books is that when they wanted to translate Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard, they said, wal-iyazu billah, Allah is the light of the skies and earth. The light of the skies and earth is a creation of Allah. Allah is not the light. Allah is the creator of the light. Ibn Abbas, the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said this ayah means Allah is the one who guided the angels, the inhabitants of the skies, and whomever Allah willed from the inhabitants of earth to the light of faith, meaning to the correct belief. At the end of the ayah, it says, يَهْدِ اللَّهُ لِنُورِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah guides to the light of faith whomever Allah willed. So what's the meaning of Allahu نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ? It doesn't mean Allah is the light, because the light is a creation of Allah. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates in whomever He willed, in the hearts of whomever He willed, the light of faith. The light of al-Iman, the correct belief. It doesn't mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is light. So all these translations, you cannot rely on them. That's why if one is new to Islam and he wants to learn, don't rush and give him a translation and say, read. Because what he's going to read is not the Quran. The Quran is in Arabic. He's going to read something written in English. And this is what that person understood from it. And now we are not in the session to mention about all these mistakes, just to give you, in general, this warning, not to rely on these translations, because they are filled with mistakes. And if one were to believe in these mistakes, he would, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى, go against the religion. So you have to be warned, you have to be cautious. The proper way to learn is to come to trustworthy people, learn from them, say, I want to know the meaning of this verse. They will explain it to you. Because it's not as it might seem to you, there will be a meaning for it. That's why we take the meanings of the Quran from trustworthy people. Who took these meanings from trustworthy people, we go back in the chain till Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, everyone will say whatever he wants about the Quran and the religion will be lost. That's why you have to be careful, brothers. نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وينفعنا بما علمنا ويزيدنا علما إنه على ما يشاء قدير وبعباده لطيف خبير والله تعالى أعلم وأحكم.